Well, hello and welcome to Grace in the Desert. Can you believe we are already in the first week of December? My mom always used to say, you know, the older you get, the faster the time goes. And I thought she was crazy, but guess what? She was right again. So today we are celebrating the second week of Advent. And our message today is shining like Jesus. So we will be continuing our Lenten journey, Arise and Shine, about the light that is in the darkness. And so if you're going to commune with us this morning, please make sure you have your bread, cracker, wafer, wine, grape juice, whatever your elements are, ready so that you can join us at the appropriate time in the service. And I think that's it. Oh, Christmas Eve, we will be worshiping at 5 o'clock. That is the Saturday at 5 o'clock. So, and look for some changes coming, moving forward as we start to plan for in-person worship here at Grace in the Desert. We're very excited about that. I think that's it. Anything? Okay. Nothing else? All right. Well, we have a theme verse for today from Zechariah 9:16. Like jewels of a crown, they shall shine on his land. And we have a response of invocation and call to worship. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Arise, shine, for your light has come.
And the glory of the Lord,
has risen upon you.
Let your light shine before others,
so that they may see your good works.
And give glory to your Father who is in heaven.
We proclaim the praises of him
who called us out of darkness
into his marvelous light.
Okay, and we are going to light the Advent wreath. Two candles today, because we are in the second week. And I believe Debbie has a children's message for us this morning.
Yes, I do. And, sorry. Has anyone ever seen jewels in a crown? Well, close your eyes and listen closely as I describe these jewels for you. When the light shines on them, the jewels create beautiful colors. Red, orange, yellow, blue, green, and purple. It's an amazing burst of beauty. Just imagine jewels in a crown. Now, we can also think of the crown of our late queen that had passed away. And her crowns were of the bright, shiny diamonds. So, again, maybe there weren't a lot of colors in her crown, but they were brilliant and bright. Now you may open your eyes. What if there was no light? What if I had an awesome crown of jewels and placed it in a dark closet, a dark basement, or a dark garage? Then what? There would be no color. Without the light, jewels have no color, no brilliance, and no beauty. Do we have any color, brilliance, or beauty when we're in the darkness of sin and selfishness? Not at all. We need the light to shine. Who is our light? Jesus is our light. And Jesus knows all about crowns, because when he was given that night that he was betrayed and he went through the badness, the enemies of him gave him a crown of thorns, and then they killed him. And after that, they didn't put Jesus in a closet or basement, But he was put in a tomb, and like a, it was like a cave in a mountain. Then they closed the tomb with a big rock. But Jesus rose from the dead. He is alive. Jesus is the light of the world. When we come to church and experience Christ's light, we begin to sparkle and shine like jewels in a crown. How amazing is that? It's what the Bible says. Like jewels in a crown, they shall shine. And we shine. Believe this or not, but we shine when we say, please, thank you, may I. We shine like dazzling jewels when we obey our parents and teachers. We are full of colors and beauty when we say our prayers and love our brothers and sisters. So remember that. Your kind words shine just like Jesus. And let Jesus always shine in your light and in your life, because we have those good words. Amen. And now let's sing our cheer to our God. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong.
Yes!
Jesus loves me.
Yes!
Jesus loves me.
Yes!
Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Amen. And now for our readings. Our first one is from the Old Testament, Zechariah, chapter 9, verses 14 to 17. Then the Lord will appear over them, and his arrow will go forth like lightning. The Lord God will sound the trumpet and will march forth in the whirlwinds of the south. The Lord of hosts will protect them, and they shall devour and tread down the sling stones. And they shall drink and roar as if drunk with wine, and be full like a bowl, drenched like the corners of the altar. On that day, the Lord their God will save them as the flock of his people, for like the jewels of a crown, they shall shine on his land. For how great is his goodness, and how great his beauty. Grain shall make the young men flourish, and new wine the young women. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our New Testament reading is from Philippians chapter 2, verses 14 to 16. Do all things without grumbling or disputing, that you may be blameless and innocent, children of God without blemish in the midst of a crooked and twisted generation, among whom you shine as lights in the world, holding fast to the word of life, so that in the day of Christ I may be proud that I did not run in vain and labor in vain. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel reading today is from Matthew chapter 5, verses 13 to 16. You are the salt of the earth, but if salt has lost its taste, how shall its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled under people's feet. You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden, nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see
your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven. This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's pray, shall we? Oh, Abba, Father God, you want us to shine. I'm not sure we always do such a good job of that, but we need your help. So please help us as we journey through the scripture readings for this morning and see how we are to shine for you, to shine like Jesus. Please wash over every place where this message is being heard with your spirit. Fill my heart with that same spirit. Fill my mouth with the words that you once spoken, so that all that is spoken and heard here today is your truth and no one else's. We ask this all in that most holy and precious name of your Son, our Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. Well, last week we heard about Jesus being the light of the world, the light in the darkness that was prophesied so long ago by the prophet Isaiah. Today, Jesus is telling us that we are the light of the world. What? What? We are to be light bearers. We are to shine like Jesus. And this was prophesied a long, long time ago in the prophet Isaiah, or not Isaiah today, Zechariah, when he said, "For like the jewels of a crown, they shall shine on his land." Now, the short-term piece of that was that the people of Israel would shine like jewels in the crown. But let's take a long-term look at this. Ultimately, this is about us as Christians. We shine with the light of Jesus. The Holy Spirit allows us to shine, shine, shine. We are to shine, like the song says, like stars in the universe. In fact, you can't see it, I don't think, but we have a canvas up on top over the altar that says, "If the stars were made to worship, so will I." We are to shine like the stars. We are to be the light in the world. Jesus came to be the light, and from his light, we shine. There's a great song called "Shine, Jesus, Shine," and I really wanted to have us sing it this morning, but that's talking about Jesus shining, not us. We are to reflect the light of Jesus in the world. Not always easy. Sometimes it's a lot easier to give in to the darkness of sin, to do things that we know we shouldn't do, to say things we know we shouldn't say. It's easier to do that. But that's not what we're called to do. We are called to be light. So, when someone has an addiction, we are called to be the light to let them see that they don't have to live that way. When somebody is engaged in sexual sin, as difficult as it may be, it is up to us to shed light in the darkness and let them know there's another way to live. For someone who doesn't see the light of tomorrow because of despair or depression or anxiety, it is up to us to shine like Jesus, to shine Jesus's light, to let them see the joy. As Paul said, "I am joyful in every circumstance." We may not be happy, but we can still be joyful. And we can let people know that, that no matter what is going on in our lives as Christians, we can shine. And we have that joy, that light of Jesus in our heart that never goes out. Think about it. Think about Think about when you're out in the middle of the desert with no street lights around. How bright are the stars? You see, even though we're in total darkness with no street lights, the stars still shine. And I gotta tell you, our world today, there's a lot of darkness going around. There's division, there's shootings, there's violence, there's, you know, people not liking each other for really pretty silly reasons. That is darkness. That is darkness overtaking the world. But we can be the light. We can shine light in that darkness. We can be that little flicker of flame that lights up the whole room, that lets people see that there's another way. We can love each other. We can shine with that light. No matter whether we agree or disagree on whatever, we still can love each other and shine the light of Jesus into lives that wouldn't normally see it. It's our job. You know, there's that other little song that I like. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. I'm not gonna hide it under a bushel basket. I'm not gonna hide it at all. I am gonna let it shine. And sometimes that can be risky, and sometimes it can be scary, and sometimes we just aren't even sure what is gonna happen when we let ourselves shine for Jesus, no matter where we are or who we're around. But our light, the light of Jesus that we carry, may be the only light that a person sees, not only on that day, but in their entire life. Shine for Jesus. No matter where you are, no matter what you're doing, no matter the risk, because here's what Jesus promised. I will be with you always. God tells us from the earliest days in Scripture, I will never leave you nor forsake you. You see, as we are shining for Jesus, we've got that light within us. We've got that light holding us, guiding us, leading us, loving us. We've got that light that shines in the darkness, so that we can shine with that reflected light of the one who is the light. What a beautiful privilege that is for us, and a responsibility too. I pray that as we go forward into this week, that we will shine like the jewels of a crown, that we will shine with the reflected light of Jesus, that we will not hide the light in order to fit in, but that we will shine brilliantly, just as the jewels of the crown on the head of a king or queen shine in the bright sunlight. You see, Jesus is our sun. We are the jewels of the crown. We are called to shine brightly, to do beautiful things, to be all that he wants us to be and do. Let's go out and do that this week. Always shine this little light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine. Let those be the words that we live by this week and always. Amen. And now let us boldly confess our faith in the words of "We Believe."
Doubt and fear.
Each petition ends a little bit differently, but your response is beauty loves the beast, and you'll kind of know, you'll be able to tell when it's time to say that. Father in heaven, you are so good. You are so faithful, and you love us so extravagantly and passionately. Empower us to believe that.
Beauty loves the beast.
You make us beautiful. Empower us to see ourselves through your eyes.
Beauty loves the beast.
You make us beautiful. Help us to focus on you and on the forgiveness we have in Christ.
Beauty loves the beast.
You make us beautiful. Send your Holy Spirit so we believe and receive this promise, that we shall shine like the jewels of a crown.
Beauty loves the beast.
You will make us beautiful, shining like jewels in your presence forever. And we
Amen.
And we have some other prayers to bring before you this morning. We have continuing prayers for my friend Barb and her mom Kate, who appears once again to be nearing the end of her earthly journey. We pray for Mark's co-worker Tim's granddaughter Angel, for Cindy's daughter-in-law Jessica, for Bernice's back, for Bernice's Aunt Rose and Bernice and Rebecca as they make decisions for her, for Jess, for Cher's great-niece Kylie, Cher's cousin Beth, Greg's friend Bob, Pastor Rachel, Joni's daughter Liz, Greg's knee, Debbie's sister-in-law Jean, who is struggling with grief, Debbie's friend William's sister for a full and complete recovery from her surgery, for those who are dealing with medical issues who do not want to be known, those who mourn, that they would feel your presence and your peace, for those seeking employment, those dealing with employment issues, and those in transition in their employment. We continue to pray for those who are in foster care and their foster families. May they be mutual support and encouragement. For those who are experiencing new beginnings, that they may be blessed by new adventures on their life journey. We continue to pray for COVID. Numbers are up a little again, but you know, this seems to just be a fact of life now. So, for our nation, oh, divided as ever. This just breaks my heart, God, and I know it's got to break yours too. So please heal our nation. Make hearts open to healing, open to accepting each other. In, you know, our differences make us beautiful, and they should not be dividing us. We pray for safe travels, for family relationships, so that those that are broken may be mended and those that are beautiful may stay that way. We continue to pray for those who serve, for the homeless and those in need, and for unbelievers. May we shine in those lives so that they see you in us. The people of the Ukraine and all who stand up to oppression, we continue to pray for Alpha. And please help us to determine when we will be starting our next Alpha. And we pray for Grace in the Desert and me as her under-shepherd. Please guide, lead, and direct us by the Holy Spirit so that all that we do is pleasing to you. No matter when, where, or how we do it, let it just be in accord with your will. We have new prayers. Oh, man, there's been some crazy weather. And earthquake, volcano in Hawaii. Just please keep everyone safe. You know, property can be replaced, but lives can't. So please keep everyone safe. And we have a praise report. My sister-in-law, Andrea, her brother Mike had successful aortic aneurysm repair surgery on Wednesday. It was quite a tricky surgery, but he is doing well. So we praise that, and we pray for continued healing for Mike and for peace and comfort for his family. Abba, we pray everything, praying that not our will but yours be done, and we ask all in that most holy and precious name of your Son, our Savior, Jesus the Christ. And all God's people said,
Amen.
Well, we are sinners all. And so, please join me in confession. Heavenly Father, it is only because of your promises of light in Christ Jesus that we come before you pleading for mercy.
Forgive the darkness within me and the darkness that surrounds me.
Forgive my many failures to shine with Christ's love and live as the light of the world.
Forgive the harsh judgments I make of others and the leniency I show myself.
Forgive the lies I tell others and the truths I avoid for myself.
Forgive the pain I cause others and the indulgence I show myself.
Well, my friends, I have beautiful, wonderful news for you. God the Father sent Jesus. He traded our unworthiness for Christ's worthiness. He traded Jesus' sinlessness for our transgressions, his purity for our uncleanness, his blazing light for our deep darkness. He sent Jesus basically to die on the cross so that we could be made clean, so that we could shine as light in the world. And it is in the stead and by the command of that very same Lord Jesus Christ, and as his called and ordained servant, that I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And may, amen, and may the glory of the Lord rise upon you. Well, this meal brings light and life to our lives like none other. As we partake of the very body and blood of Jesus Christ, we are being fed. Our spirits and our souls are being fed in a way that nothing else can do. We receive the light, and we are called then to shine with that light. And on that night when he was handed over to die for the sins of the world, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had blessed it, he broke it and he gave it to his disciples. And he said, take and eat. This is my body given for you for the forgiveness of all your sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Oops, wrong one. I was getting ahead of myself. Sorry, God. And then he took the cup of redemption. And after he had blessed it and given thanks, he gave it to his disciples and he said, take and drink. This is my blood, the blood of a new covenant given for you for the forgiveness of all your sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. These are the gifts of God for all of us, God's people. And now let's pray that prayer that Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
And now please commune as we commune here. Great, the body of Christ is given for you.
Amen.
And the blood of Christ is shed for you.
Amen. Surely the body of Christ is given to you.
Amen.
And the blood of Christ is shed for you.
Amen. And now may this body that was given for all of us and this blood that was shed for all of us keep us all in the true faith until life everlasting. Depart in that peace that only comes from the giver of this meal. Amen. And now please join me in our offering prayer. Lord, let our congregation be a witness to you. Immersed in scripture, constant in prayer, joyful in worship, generous in giving, a loving, supportive community, reaching out to those in need. Accept these gifts we offer In Jesus' name, amen. And we have a responsive benediction. So I'm going to just stand over here so you can see it, but I can still do the blessing. Arise, shine, for your light has come.
And the glory of the Lord has risen upon you.
Let your light shine before others,
so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven.
Go and serve the Lord as peace and light bearers. Amen.
Amen.
Go in peace and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen. Well, thank you for joining us today. Next week, we will have week 3 of our Advent journey, which means we are getting closer to Christmas. Our message next week will be ultimate healing, and we will see how the light of Jesus works ultimate healing in us. We ask blessings on your day and on your week, and we will see you next week. God bless.